According to ESPN, Yahoo, NFL, CBS, Sleeper, Underdog Fantasy, FFPC, Christian McCaffrey is the 101 in fantasy football drafts this year. CeeDee Lamb is right behind him at the 102, Tyreek Hill at the 103. I have yet to see a single draft in which one of those three players was not the first overall pick outside of Superflex, of course. Today's video, I am here banging the table to make the case that you should consider the Detroit Lions wide receiver, amon-ra, St. Brown, the sun god, to be the number one overall pick in fantasy football drafts this year. And listen, I get it. Saying that amon-ra, St. Brown is a good fantasy football pick this year is a take that is about as spicy as ketchup. But right now, his ADP is 107, 108, 109 in these other leagues, in these other formats, on these other sites. I think the take overall will get heated. It'll get spicy as we get to the end of it. So let's tell the story of amon-ra, St. Brown to get to the point where we want to draft a number one overall. Last year, he broke out in, you know, predictable fashion, caught 119 passes, 1,515 yards, 10 touchdowns. He missed a game last year. He was playing with a fully torn oblique, among other serious injuries. Those 119 catches, that was one of the single highest reception seasons in NFL history. If you know anything about the former USC Trojan, Mr. amon-ra, St. Brown, you know that his work ethic rivals like only overseas Apple employees. He got this work ethic from, you know, the narrative is kind of tired at this point, but his father was a two-time Mr. Olympia. Okay, so he instilled this like healthy lifestyle. He instilled this go get 'em, work hard every single day, get better, you know, that like kind of corny attitude that also makes you a fucking all pro NFL wide receiver. He's got that work ethic. And I think the most exemplary piece of how we saw that come to play is how he has linearly progressed year over year over year. His rookie year, 90 catches, 900 yards, 5 touchdowns. His sophomore year, 106 catches, 1,160 yards, 6 touchdowns. Last year, as I said, 119 catches, over 1,500 yards and 10 touchdowns. It's very rare that you find a purely linear upswing in terms of progression as an NFL player. A lot of the times you see, you know, breakouts after a couple of years, up and down, spike years, you're great, you're okay, you're fine, you're great again, all over the place. amon-ra, St. Brown, his linear success feels very, very much a product of the way that he is wired and his mindset of like getting better each day. Now, amon-ra came into the league as a slot receiver out of USC, an above average route runner. He had like a knack for finding soft spots in the zone, and that's where a lot of his production came from. But he has since flourished into one of the league's best all-around route runners. He had the fifth highest win rate versus all of man coverage last year per player profiler. So not only is he a great slot receiver, not only can he find open spots in the zone, but now he has developed into one of the elite route runners all around. The man is simply always open, and when he's not open, he still is, okay? St. Brown had the NFL's fifth highest contested catch rate last year. He came down with 64% of the contested targets last year. Not only is he getting open, but when he's not getting open, he's coming down with the passes that are coming his way in contested situations, and when he does catch the ball, he's making plays after the fact. The Lions slot receiver had the second most yards after the catch in the NFL last year. 668 of his yards came after the catch. amon-ra is simply the apple of Jared Goff's eye. He literally never stops throwing him the ball, no matter what part of the field they're on, right? Last year, St. Brown had 25 red zone targets, third most amongst all wide receivers. He played 19 games last year, including playoffs, right? 16 regular season, 3 playoff games. Out of 19 games, he failed to hit 70 yards 3 times. Okay, so he was above 70 yards in 85% of the games. He failed to hit 6 receptions in a game 3 times. He had 6 or more catches in 85% of his games. He went over 100 receiving yards in 10 of 19 games. 53% of his games, he topped 100 receiving yards. And then the Lions went out and rewarded him this offseason. Gave him a 4-year, $120 million extension. When I look at amon-ra, St. Brown, I think it's clear that his floor is as high as any player in all of fantasy football. And that is thanks to sound play from Jared Goff, the number one ranked offensive line in the NFL, and an aggressive head coach that loves to go for it on fourth down and loves to keep his offense on the field. People like to talk about Jared Goff and, you know, his ups and downs. He can't play here, he can't play there. Throughout his career, Jared Goff has averaged 4,350 passing yards and 27 passing touchdowns per season in seasons which his team had a winning record. The Lions are currently projected to win 10.5 games per Vegas. They are projected one of the highest win totals in the NFL. well. This is going to be a very good team. Jared Goff is going to put up very good stats. And the other reason I know that he's going to put up very good stats is because the Lions play in a dome and the Lions play 14 of their first 15 games indoors. When you think of the NFC North and you think of Green Bay, and when you think of Chicago, you think of hard-nosed, cold football, Jared Goff's little hands shriveling and he can't throw the ball. 14 of the first 15 games are indoors for him. So while I love amon-ra St. Brown's floor, I would argue that there is a ton of meat left on the bone, and here's why. While he saw the third most red zone targets last year, right? Red zone is just 20-yard line or in. When you're getting targets at like the 19, the 18, the 14, even like the 11, they're good, they're fine, but the likelihood of you catching a ball out there and scoring a touchdown is very low. So 25 red zone targets, amon-ra St. Brown had 5 end zone targets last year. That was tied for 59th amongst NFL wide receivers. Alec Pierce, Nick Westbrook-Ikhine, Brandon Johnson all had the same number of end zone targets as amon-ra St. Brown last year. Darnell Mooney had more than he did. When I look at Detroit's offense last year, do you know who led the team in end zone targets? It wasn't Sam Laporta. It wasn't amon-ra St. Brown. It wasn't Gibbs, Montgomery. It wasn't any of these guys. It was Josh Reynolds. Josh Reynolds had 8 end zone targets last year. Josh Reynolds is no longer on the team. Sam Laporta was right behind him with 7. And then amon-ra down at 5. When they were inside the 5-yard line last year, not only did those guys get targeted at a higher rate than amon-ra St. Brown, but let's look at the fucking running backs, the carries that were going on inside the 5-yard line. David Montgomery, top 5 in the NFL. He had 19 goal line carries. Jahmyr Gibbs had 11. Craig Reynolds, 4. Craig Reynolds had as many opportunities inside the 5-yard line as amon-ra St. Brown last year. Jared Goff, 2. Okay? So imagine a world where David Montgomery, Jahmyr Gibbs, Jared Goff, Craig Reynolds don't combine for 26 rushing touchdowns. Imagine a world where Josh Reynolds is not getting 8 end zone targets. Imagine a world where amon-ra St. Brown starts to become a bigger piece of the end zone playbook down there. And he jumps from 5 end zone targets to 10, 11, 12. This man's touchdown upside in what's projected to be a top 5 scoring offense in the NFL, I genuinely think could start to flirt with 13, 14, 15, 16. So amon-ra St. Brown gives you a floor borderline unlike any player in the NFL. He is giving you 13 PPR fantasy points every single week, no matter what. He has improved year over year over year, no matter what. He has transformed himself from a good receiver at USC to an elite route runner, separator, catcher of the football at the NFL level. He is padded by the fact that he is in a phenomenal offense. They have a great offensive line. They have a quarterback that thrives when he is in good conditions. Jameson Williams is here, but realistically, they don't have a high volume pass catcher behind amon-ra St. Brown. He missed the game last year and still went fucking bananas. I don't think we've seen the best of amon-ra St. Brown. I think we've seen what he'll do at his worst. I don't think we've seen the touchdown upside of what can happen if their goal line playbook, if they're inside the 10-yard line, 5-yard line, starts to veer more towards one of the best playmakers in the NFL. I don't think it's a stretch to ask for that, especially with their leading end zone target guy, Josh Reynolds, no longer on the team. Sure, David Montgomery is going to eat. Jahmyr Gibbs is going to eat. But that is so much opportunity down there on the goal line. Jared Goff loves amon-ra. The chemistry is almost unmatched at the NFL level. They were top 10 in offensive pace last year. Their fantasy playoff strength of schedule for quarterbacks in the passing game is number 5 in the NFL this year. Their strength of schedule in the beginning of the season, what we're calling the fast start strength of schedule in our draft guide, which is available on August 1st, but you could pre-order it right now. We'll have all these stats in there for you, is number 2 for the passing game. I don't see a single negative argument for amon-ra St. Brown. And the only argument I can give you is why he's only going to continue to get better and why with more opportunities are going to come way more valuable opportunities, right? It's not like he led the league in end zone targets. It's not like he scored 16 touchdowns. There is room for improvement there. There is room for him to play all 17 games. There is room for him not to get injured. There is room for him to just go fucking bananas playing in a dome for the entire first 3-4 months of the season. Amon-ra St. Brown in full PPR leagues should be very, 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 very top of the list as a considerable candidate. Shout out to the fucking presidential campaign for amon-ra St. Brown as the 101. Okay, so obviously he is a must-draft player for me this year. He is the number one player in the draft guide on the must draft list. If you are interested in getting analysis like this for all the players that I think you have to come away with your drafts from this year, as well as all our rankings, you know, PPR, standard, half PPR, those stats that I mentioned in our tiebreaker matrix, available in our draft guide, underdogfantasy.com. If you go deposit on the website, this is the cheapest way to get it. Deposit $10 or more using promo code BDGE. You're going to get the draft guide absolutely free when it launches on August 1st, or you can go pre-order it right now for a discounted price on BDGE.co. All right. If you're taking amon-ra 101, let me know. I don't think you'll be disappointed.